I am Nishant.
This is Abdul Bhagat. We are pursuing engineering in Sri Manakula Nagar Engineering College from the stream of Computer Science and Engineering. Let us discuss about our problem statement. The main objective of our problem statement to containerize a web Java based web application and maintain with the Kubernetes by auto scaling and auto balancing technology. Let us discuss about our domain explanation. First we can discuss about a DevOps. It is an agile model of developing where a developer team and a operating team work together in a better understanding way. This gives us an effective way of development for the application. These have five important steps of cycles. They are continuous deployment, continuous testing, continuous integration, continuous deployment, and continuous monitoring. This process is automated by a DevOps method by a development team. Next, we can discuss about a Docker. Docker is an open platform to create, manage, and deploy visual application in a containerized on a common OS. Usually, container consists of an application with all its dependencies that are packed in it. Docker also provides security for the application by running them in a shared environment. Docker also provides a containerized application in the form of the images. These images helps in running the application as many times when required. Here I use Docker to containerize my application to make them work in effective way on the basis of the problem statement. Next, we move to the main concept, Kubernetes. Kubernetes is an open source system to automate the containerized application. Docker does not provide a feature such as auto-scaling of a container, load balancing, and rollback system of the container. These features are provided by the Kubernetes and automated in this feature are also done in the Kubernetes. Kubernetes basically basic principle work with the master-slave relationship. In Kubernetes, nodes usually control different slaves. Nodes there are ports. These ports consist of different containers in them. Master nodes usually manage the cluster, and the node where the cluster is used to manage the different types of containers. The nodes are used to host the ports. The nodes are used to host the ports that consist of containerized application in them. These ports will interact and communicate with each other to route the traffic between them. In this way, the Kubernetes works on three major tools used for integrating a Kubernetes. They are kubeadm, kubelet, kubect, and the kubeadm is used to create the master node in the Kubernetes. The kubelet is used to manage the process in the nodes. The kubectl is used for communication in the node. Next, we are going to see the main domain, Jenkins. Jenkins is the open source automation server written in Java, which is used to continuous integration and continuous deployment. Continuous integration is development practice where the developer integrates the code into a shared repository frequently. Preferably several times a day. Each integration can be verified by the automated build and automated test. One of the key benefit of integrating regularly is that you can detect error quickly and locate them more easily. As every change introduced is typically small, pinpointing the specific change that introducing a defect can be done quickly. Continuous deployment is closely related to the continuous integration and refer to keep your application deployable at any point or even automatically releasing to the test or productive environment if the latest version passes all automated tests. Continuous delivery. It is a practice of keeping a code-based development at any point. Beyond making sure your application pass automated tests, it has to have all configuration necessary to push it into the production. Many teams then do push change that pass the automated test into our test or production environment immediately to ensure a fast development tool.
Jenkins key matrix are adoption. Jenkins matrix are adoption. Jenkins is widespread with more than 147,000 active installation and over 1 million users around the world. Plugins. Jenkins is interconnected with well over 1,000 plugins that allows to integrate with most of the development, testing and deploy tools.
On the basis of the problem statement, here I have used AWS EC2 to create my cluster with one master and one slave node. The master work is to maintain the worker node. The slave node consists of two containers. One is application, web application, which is hosted with help of Tomcat server, and other consists of MySQL database. Server to store the data. The two containerized application are pulled as an Docker image and then deployed in a container-based system. These two containers are connected with each other with the help of the bridge network. Let's move on to the working method. Here the source code is pushed on the GitHub, which is the source code management system. Then, using Jenkins, the product is deployed in the working environment. At the first, the Jenkins will pull the source code from the given GitHub link. Then the source code is built and tested using Maven, which is the build tool, once the build is successful. Then the source code is converted into a var file. Initially, the var is transferred to the slave node where Docker is installed, then the post-build access takes place. At first, it checks for any running container in the node. It found it will stop the container and delete the Docker image from the node. Then creates a new Docker image with the new var file. Once image is created, then the MySQL image is started in the network, and the created Docker image will also be linked in the network. The var file is hosted with the help of the Tomcat. Tomcat will host the web app in the local machine. If there is any change in the code, then the Jenkins will identify it. Then once again, it will test and build the change code. Once successful, then the deployment process started.
Now let's move on to the installation of Kubernetes. Move to the AWS console in the EC2. Running instances. I have created two instances. One is master node, slave node instance. Both are Ubuntu instances. I have created my slave instance. So let's move on to installation things that are required in instances. So first thing, installation is apt get install y apt transport https. This is used to route the traffic which is coming to the instances, and it is one of the important installation command. Next we move to the installation of Kubernetes, which is done using the curl as http package cloud.google.com. This is used to get the Kubernetes, and the following commands are used to create a directory for the Kubernetes. Next we move on to the installation of Docker. App get install docker.io used to install the Docker instances. So let me show you what type of version I have installed in docker --- version. Here I used 18.9.7. so let's move further to the installation of the next installation is kubelet, kubeadm, kubectl. These are the most important thing. So first we are using kubeadm to create a master node. This helps in installation of tools automatically and automatic configuration of API server and control management. Next, kube let is used to the manage the processes happening in the nodes. And third thing is kubectl, which is used for communication between the nodes. This performs all type of communication that are happening between the nodes. Then we are moving to the creation of cluster. KubeADM is used to create a cluster in the node. Once a node is cluster is created, you will get a token. Such as KubeADM join with an IP. This is used to join the master node and the slave node. Then we are move on to the making of directory. Mkdir is used to make the directory of for the Kubernetes. Then I have inserted the CNI networks here. The following commands create a CNI networks. Now we are move to the slave instances. We can connect a slave instance through IP. So let me show you whether they are already created the things. Now I show you they are connected using a kubectl get nodes. This so it should be root user when you are so now you can see this command use the two IP address of master and slave. They both are interconnected with each other and the status shows that they are in ready state or not in ready state. And that's all about the care. Here we move on to the Kubernetes parts. I have used AWS EC2 service. I just created a Kubernetes cluster by using one master and another one slave node. They are connected with each other with the help of the token that is generated by the master. This is a token used to generate it and used to connect the two instances with each other. So let us check the both the instances are connected with each other with the command. So this is the master instance. In this, both the master and the slave are interconnected with each other. And shows the state of the master and slave node. The security group is that the security groups that I used is HTTP customs using of accessing a port 8080, MySQL Aurora for port number 3306, and the Kubernetes is 8, and the Docker is installed in both the master and the slave node. The data stored in the container can be viewed using the command. It will ask for the password. Getting onto the database. We are using the command select star from the student database. Then the data is viewed, which is stored in the database. Now let's move on to the Jenkins pack. Currently in this layer there is no container running, and I am going to auto deploy my web app in this layer. To do that, I am creating a Windows instance in the AWS EC2 Jenkins. Once the Windows instance is created, I am logging onto it. After logging, I am using the command javachar jenkins.var to start the Jenkins in the localhost 8080. Once the server is connected, the dashboard looks like this. On this dashboard, I have created my Jenkins project in the auto deployment and configured it. The source code management. Source code management is used to manage my source code. I have used GitHub repository for my source code management system. This is the repository where my Able project is placed. This is my Maven project, which is in the GitHub. Then build the figure. Build trigger is used to trigger Jenkins in the any change in the code in the repository. I have measured the schedule, which indicates that the Jenkins monitor the GitHub repository for any change in the code. If there is any change in the code, the new project is pulled and then the automatically built. Since I have created a Maven project, I am using Maven version 3.6.2. My goal is to convert my Maven project into a WAR file. So I am using colon package, which converts my project into a WAR file. Once the build is successful, then Jenkins will try to perform the post build action. At first, in the post build action, it will send the generated WAR file to the slave node to create a Docker image using the Docker file. The command used to create a Docker file in then their deployed app, docker build web app dot. This is a command which will create a Docker image using the WAR file in the Docker image. Then the Docker network create driver bridge my network will create a network. Then I am starting up my MySQL server. This command will link the MySQL server to the network. Then to start the my web app, I am using the command docker run, which will start the my web app. When the post build action is successful, then the container will get start. Here now there are two more extra containers other than the Kubernetes, which is MySQL and the web app which I have created. This web app get hosted in the local server of the instance using the compiler, which can be viewed by using the public DNS of the slave instance. The contender is reacted, which can be viewed in this layer node. These are the two containers which are started using Jenkins. One is the web app and another is MySQL server. These containers are hosted in the localhost of this instance, which can be viewed using the public DNS IPv4/sample app. This is the web app which is being deployed in the compiler after filling the required things in the given tab, then click the submit button. The registration is successful, which means the data is stored in the MySQL server, which is running in the container.
Thank you.
Thank you.